What's going on, y'all? Real Films 1998 here, and today we're going to be talking about The Card Counter. The Card Counter is a crime drama produced by the legendary Martin Scorsese. This film is written and directed by the also legendary Paul Schrader. It stars Oscar Isaac, Tiffany Haddish, and Ty Sheridan. Willem Dafoe also plays a smaller main part, but he isn't in it as much as the other main cast. This film follows blackjack player and professional card counter William Tell, played by Oscar. From the moment that the title card transitions into the other cast and crew, you see that they're going to be unique and seamless throughout the entire film. While this does stay true to that for the most part, there were a decent amount of scenes that cut completely to black for anywhere from 5 to 30 seconds, and it makes the pacing a bit jarring. William Tell goes from casino to casino playing blackjack and winning just enough to live and continue doing that same thing over and over again. In his opening monologue, he states that he likes routine behavior, and that stays true for the whole story. At one of the casinos, he's approached by Kirk with a C, as he introduces himself at least. They are both at a lecture from an old general, and Kirk gives Tell a paper with his name and number and says to contact him. Tell also seems to meet this woman, Lalinda, played by Tiffany Haddish. She seems to tell him that she's been watching him play for a while and she thinks he has what it takes to win some bigger money. At first he doesn't want to do it, but after a bit of persuasion, he does eventually agree. Later on, when Tell reaches back out to Kirk, he realizes that he was in the service with Kirk's father back in the day. So he decides to take him along from casino to casino while he plays blackjack. He feels guilty for the sins of his past and decides to help out this kid with his college payment and things of that nature, any type of debt that he had. Once Tell agrees to work with Lalinda, he goes and starts playing the World Series Poker Tour. She sets up another guy to be at his table so he can make the winning pot have more money in it. There's a specific term for that, but I can't remember it off the top of my head. If you know the term, be sure to let me know in the comment section down below. Some films like this I don't think had a great execution. However, Oscar Isaac gives such a compelling performance and it holds the entire film together. Tiffany Haddish and Ty Sheridan were great in it as well, but the standout is definitely Oscar. Overall, I really did enjoy this film, but I didn't find it to be anything new or innovative like I thought it could be for the genre. The main issue I feel that it had was pacing. The first 30 minutes of the film or so were paced perfectly. Then the entire story feels like it comes to a halt between the second and third acts, almost as if the middle chunk of the film was filler. The third act is paced overly fast as well. I'm not sure what Paul's exact vision was for this film, to be honest. By the time we started the third act, I was confused on the intentions of the characters. There's this one scene in particular with Tell and Kirk towards the end of the film. Without giving too much away, I wasn't sure what either of their intentions were at the moment. I guess the one thing I wish they did better was flesh out the story so that the moments didn't feel slow, well-paced, and fast all in the same film. I'm gonna give this an 8 out of 10. The story definitely falls flat on some levels for me, but the performances mainly by Oscar bring this film back up to above average to good for me. Have you seen The Card Counter? Did you love it? Did you hate it? If you've seen it, be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Once I get to 100 subscribers, I'm going to be giving away a digital code for the Raimi trilogy. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to stay up to date with all the latest content and giveaways. Peace!